There comes the program detail module. From this program detail module, the role of head of the departments is there into the system. Again, like mission, vision, program educational objectives, program outcomes and program specific outcomes can be mentioned. Please note that if program educational objective, this is the specific terminology directly related to the NBA, National Board of Accreditation Systems of the professional institutions. Higher education institutions may be dealing with the program outcomes and program specific outcomes, mission and vision and missions. They may not have the program educational objective, but if some autonomous institutions or certain university status institutions are having this, then they can mention about. But if not applicable to you, you can omit this. Okay. See, for professional institutions, these program outcomes are given by the National Board of Accreditations. But for higher educational institutions, these program outcomes may or may not be given by the university or the Directorate of Higher Education, but every individual institution can have this setup with them. And these are the program specific outcomes. Okay, after this, there is the another link for students enrollment category wise. This is very important. This is asked many times into the various manual processes. Here I can go and add. See, here all possible levels are provided: diploma, graduation, post graduation, MPhil, PhD, add-on programs. Okay, these are, let us say, diploma. Diploma is the program. Okay, but what is the program type? This can be the diploma of arts, commerce, science, isn't it? Like this, suppose I am adding the graduation. So graduation is the program under graduation, and BA is the type of that particular program. There can be BCom, BSc, like this. Okay, and for that program, see here, only what I have entered, that is appearing. In your institution's registration, you have added many things, and according to those, your graduation, post-graduation, all these links will be available, and their type of program will be available. Selection, even academic year-wise, you can proceed further and register your programs and register the students who have got admitted in that program in that particular academic year. The students enrolled category wise, students enrolled territory wise also. See, territory wise means there are certain autonomous institutions who have got the permission to give the admission to the person from Indian origin, NRI, foreign students. All that information can be entered through this territory wise link. Just to have the gist, see, you can add Divyangajan, PWD students, male, female, transgender, then foreign students, person from of Indian origin, NRI, other states and states. And this information is asked by the NAC at various levels for assessment. Then the student support scheme link is there. After student support scheme, new course information is there. Then see, new course information is it something else than the program information. These are the new courses added. There can be the certificate courses, there can be the diploma courses. Some autonomous institutions or universities may start some 3-month certification course, 6-month certification course. That information is again asked by the NAC. That information you can feed is a new course information, and we have tried to use, to avoid the confusion, we are using all possible nomenclatures that NAC or NBA or other accreditation agencies are following, like new course information. Okay, then students placement detail, then progression to higher education details, that is how many students have promoted from diploma to degree, degree to post graduation to MPhil or PhD, and PhD to postdoc, all that. That can be, you can enter over here. okay, then the students organized activity, students participated activities. These are the two different links. Student organized means the activities organized by the institute, by the department. That information can be entered over here along with the beneficiary of that activity. Then the student's participation, then alumni contribution, then the student's performance in the final year. This student's performance in the final year matters a lot as a specific outcome of the department. May not be for, maybe for the NAC, but it is more crucial for the NBA type of accreditation. What is your student performance? There are separate criteria in the NAC and in the NBA processes also, but the weightages are given as a student performance because this is our ultimate outcome of the institute in the form of students' achievement. Okay, then the alumni association activities. Alumni contribution is something else. It can be in terms of monetary, in terms of kinds, and alumni association activities. Every institution is supposed to have registered alumni cell, and through that alumni cell, various activities are being conducted. So all those activities you can register over here through this alumni association activities. Then students qualifying exam details. See, students qualifying exam details, these are again taken at two different levels. One is the student qualifying examination for higher studies, and another is student qualifying examination for their placements and for their like MPSC, UPSC or civil services examinations. And these two tables are available and asked by the NAC in two different formats. So all that you can make entry through this particular link. Then the value added courses, new course addition and value added courses, these are the two different things and asked in two different criteria at two different, with two different formats in the NAC processes. So that value added courses are also taken care of and you can add over here. Then the field projects and internships. Most possibly it is applicable for all sorts of institutions, but more applicable towards for the professional institutions like engineering, pharmacy, MBA, and the design courses like architecture. Then there comes the differently able students, Divyangajan. Details about the info, detail in, earlier you have entered the facilities of Divyangajan. Here, the differently able students detail information you have to fill up. Then the sanction intake of this program. This is the responsibility of head of the department. So all this information under the program detail module is to be entered by head of the department. Please make a note of this. This is not the IQAC responsibility. This is the responsibility of head of the department. But depending on the nature and culture of the institute, see, we try to cater all type of institution state-wise and possibly nationwide also. Here, in some of the institutions, there are separate Divyangajan cell. Then respective head of the department can coordinate it with that separate cell and get the information and complete the process. Because what is the volume of the number of students of that institution? What are number of programs? Because there are many institutions running more than 100 programs even. So in that case, it comes decentralization. So that decentralization is again with certain defined portfolios. And through that portfolio, head of the department is supposed to have liaisoning, is supposed to have coordination and complete this process. Okay. Then once this is completed by the head of the department, about 80% role of the head of the department is over. And it will reduce minimum 40% burden of IQAC. IQAC in charges will be happy to know this. Like head of the department will also come to know, will be happy when they will come to know about the faculties. So entire arrangement is made that this software is hierarchical in a structured way designed and defined. So it is, I can say, burden reduced software also as an individual portfolio. For IQAC, now the 40% is reduced. For the once these all entered by the head of the department, his 40% burden will be 80% burden from the head of department will be reduced.